In this tutorial, we will learn to create this funnel 3D model in AutoCAD 2023. And here is drawing for it. We release new videos every alternate Monday, Wednesday and Saturday. To receive notification, please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this tutorial. Now, this drawing is in inches. Therefore, we will use acad.dwt as a template. So, click here on this arrow and click here on acad.dwt. And if acad.dwt is not available, you can also click here on browse templates. And from here, you can select it and click on open. Then to check units, type UN, press enter. So, here unit is selected as inches. So, we will not make any changes to these settings. Click on OK. Then, I have kept here dynamic input on. Object snap tracking is also on. Object snap is on. And if you click here on this arrow. So, I have selected these endpoint, midpoint, center, quadrant intersection and extension object snap. So, in this object, at first we will create some profiles. So at first we will create this internal cut profile. So here length is given as 6.310. Then radius of this circle is 2.25. That is diameter is 4.5. Then here is elliptical fillet of 1/1.5 radius. So at first we will create one rectangle of 6.310 size by 4.5. That is double of this radius. So click here on rectangle, then specify first point here, take your cursor away, then specify distance of 6.310, press tab, 4.5, enter, then zoom there. Then we want here fillet of 2.25 radius. So for that click here on fillet, then right click, click here on radius, specify radius of 2.25, enter. Again right click, click on multiple, then select this line, then this line and this line, then right click, enter. Then we will need here elliptical fillet of 1/1.5 radius. So for that we will create one ellipse. So click here on ellipse, then right click, click here on from. Click on this base point, then type add symbol, then in x direction we want distance of 1.5, comma, and in y direction actually we will be going down, that means we will be going in negative y direction, so type here negative sign, then specify distance of 1, enter, then make ortho mode on, then take your cursor to this endpoint and track it and click. Again, take your cursor to this midpoint. Don't click there, take it away. So it will track it. Then click. So here this ellipse is created. Then we want same ellipse on the opposite side also. So we will mirror it. So type MI for mirror. Enter, then select this ellipse. Enter. Then first point of mirror line will be this midpoint. Click. Take your cursor on this side. Click. And click here on no. Then we will trim unwanted objects. For that type TR for trim, enter, then click here and click here. Same way click here, here, again click here and click here, press enter. So here this top profile is ready. Then next is to create these circles of dia 0.45 and dia 1. So type C for circle, enter, then take your cursor over this circle and click here on this center point, take your cursor away, then radius will be 0.5 for one dia circle, press enter, then again press enter to repeat circle command, then take your cursor over this circle, click here on this center, then right click, click on diameter, so diameter is 0.45, enter. So here these two circles are also ready. So using this data, we will create this object in 3D. So here our 2D work is done. So we will switch to 3D modeling. For that, click here on this arrow and click here on 3D modeling. Then click here on unsaved view and click here on SE isometric. Now this circle of dia 1 is at the height of 3.25 and this circle of dia 45 is at the height of 2. So what we will do, we will move this circle at those height. So for that, type here M for move, press enter, then select this circle, enter, specify base point in empty space, then take your cursor below, ensure that ortho mode is on, type here 3.25, enter, then again enter to repeat last command, then select this circle, enter, then specify base point at this center point. Then I want to move it at the distance of 2 from this circle. So for that, shift plus right click, click here on from, then specify base point at this center point, take your cursor below, specify distance of 2, enter. So here these circles are located at perfect locations. Then I don't want these grid lines, so click here on grid mode. Then we will have to create some guidelines so that it will be connected straight. So we will create one line from this midpoint to this quadrant point. We will have to make that line on this ZX plane. So for that we will have to change our UCS. So to work on this ZX plane, we will have to use front UCS. So click here on world, then click here on front. So here you will see that our XY plane is aligned perfectly. Then type L for line, press enter, then click here on this midpoint, then zoom there, take your cursor to this center point and take it away. Now it is not tracking because ortho mode is on. So we will turn ortho mode off, then here it is tracking perfectly. Then click, then enter, enter. Again, track this center point, click, and click here on this endpoint. Enter. Then next is to create these reference lines from this endpoint to this quadrant point. So for that, again, we will have to work on this YZ plane. So to align to YZ, click here and click here on right. So here our XY is aligned perfectly. Then again, type L for line. Enter, then click here on this intersection point, zoom there, take your cursor to this center point, don't click there, take it away so it will track it, and click here on this intersection point. Then enter, enter, then again take your cursor to this center point, take it away, click, and click here on this intersection point. Press escape. So here our basic work is ready. So after converting this object into 3D, this circle will be removed. So what we will do, we will need that circle. So we will just copy it and place it at other location. So type CO for copy, enter, select this circle, enter, specify base point and click here. Press escape. Then we will have to convert this object into 3D. So before that, we will have to join this shape so that a single object will be created. So for join, type J, enter, then select these objects, press enter. So here this object is converted into single object. Then to convert this object into 3D, you will have to use loft command. So for loft, click here on this arrow below extrude and click here on loft. So loft is basically useful to connect different sections and create 3D objects. So click here on loft, then select this circle and this profile. Then press enter, click here on guides and select these lines. Then press enter. Then to see it in solid format, click here on 2D wireframe and click here on shaded. So here this object is perfectly converted into our desired shape. Then to convert this object, again we will use loft command. So click here on loft, then select this circle and press enter. And click here on cross sections only. Then we will move it and place it here. For that type M, enter, select this object, enter. Then base point will be the center point and we will copy it at this center point. So here this object is ready. Then now these are separate objects. To convert them into single object, we will have to use union command. So click here on solid union, then command name is union. You can also type union if required. Click here on solid union, then select this object, press enter. So here this object is converted into single object. Then we want this object to be hollow. So for that we will have to use shell command. So for hollow, thickness will be 0.06. So for shell, click here on this arrow near separate and click here on shell. Then select this 3D solid, then remove faces. So I want to remove this top face, click on it. Same way we will have to remove this bottom face. So click on it also. Then press enter. Then thickness is 0.06. Enter and press escape. So here this hollow shape is perfectly ready. Then next is to create this outside portion. Now here length is 7.625 between this point to this point. Then this radius is 2.5. That means this distance will be 5. So here at first we will create this rectangle of 7.625 by 5. And then we will apply these fillets of 2.5 radius. Now we will have to create this rectangle on this top surface. So for that click here and click on top. So here our XY plane is horizontal. Then click here on rectangle. Specify first point here. Take your cursor away. Then type here 7.625. Then press tab. Then 5. Enter. Then apply fillets. For that click here on fillet. Then right click. Radius 2.5. Enter. Right click polyline, select this rectangle. So here this shape is ready. Then we will have to move this shape here. Then to work out this gap, we will have to subtract this 2.25 from this 2.5. That means it will be 0.25. So click here on move, then select this object, enter, then base point will be the same point. Pan it, zoom it, then take your cursor to this midpoint. Okay, now it is not showing any point here. And if we take here, it is not showing any point. So basically it is showing only point at this end point. It is showing reference only at this end point. So we will move it using this reference. Press escape. Again click here on move. Select this object, enter, then click here on this endpoint, take your cursor here, and take your cursor to this endpoint, then don't click there, take it away, so it will track it, then specify here distance of 0.25, enter. So here it has been placed perfectly. Then to convert this shape into 3D, click here on this arrow, click here on extrude. Select this shape, enter, take your cursor below, specify thickness of 0.06, enter. Then we will need one cut here, so for that click here on press pull, take your cursor inside, once it gets highlighted click, take it below, then type height of 0.06, enter. So here it has been cut perfectly, press escape. Then next is this cut. Now here this distance is 1, then this distance is 0.25 and this circle radius is 0.125. So we will create this shape. So at first we will create this rectangle of 0.25 by 1. Again take it away, zoom there, rectangle, specify first corner point, take it away, width is 0.25, press tab, length is 1, enter, then zoom there, then type C for circle, enter, then center point will be at this midpoint, click, take it away, radius is 0.125, enter. Then to apply ear fillets, click here on fillet, then right click, radius will be 0.125, that is half of 0.25, enter, then right click, click on polyline, select this rectangle, then trim unwanted portion, type TR, enter, click, and escape. So here this shape is ready. Now this shape is located at the gap of 0.425 from this midpoint. So again type M for move, press enter, select this object, enter, zoom there, then click here on this midpoint, then zoom here, take your cursor to this midpoint, don't click there, take it away, it will track it, then specify here 0.425, enter. Okay, it has been copied from below side. No problem, we can cut from that side also. So to cut, click here on press pull and click inside this shape, take your cursor on this side and click, press escape. So here it has been cut perfectly. Then to convert this object into single object, click here on union, select these objects, press enter. Then to change color, just double click on it, click here, again click here and choose your desired color, press escape. So here this object is ready. I don't want this circle, type E, enter, click in empty space and click and press enter. So here this object is perfectly ready. Please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.